Hey, y'all, Billy from Permapastors Farm. It's the 14th, and tonight, 8 p.m. Eastern, we're going live, so be sure to check us out. Now, I'm going to get right into it. Ain't that right, milk boy? Okay, as of late, and I don't know why, maybe it's like, you know, when you buy a car and then you notice all the other cars like it, but as of late, a lot of people have been saying, they've been asking, they've been writing in comments, they've been emailing, and also in conversations I've had in meetings and otherwise, there's been this thing where so many people are saying, hey, man, I would love to raise chickens. I would love to do this. I would love to do that. I would love to have cows, but they only allow horses here. In fact, that was a conversation that just happened last week. All these different things that are unfolding, it seems to be happening, or maybe I'm just noticing it more. So we're going to address that today. We're going to show you how we deal with it. And honestly, these are effective tips. So give them a shot.
Good evening. I'm the code enforcer for the HOA, and the reason for my visit is because I've received a few code violations. You mind if I come check out the place?
Well, you were smart to not just walk up on my property. This ain't the kind of place you want to come up unannounced. But since you asked politely, I'll go ahead and consent. Now, you're saying that there's code violations? Come on in. Maybe we'll talk about it. Forgive my little companion here. He can be a little rambunctious. What code complaints are you talking about?
You mind if we take a look at your chickens over here? We've heard that you've had a couple roosters over here crowing early in the morning.
Well, yeah, I do mind, but we'll go ahead and walk over here and we'll just discuss what you got in mind. Let's go take a look at them.
I see a rooster over there, and as you know, there's an ordinance here at this HOA saying that roosters aren't allowed.
Oh, really? Well, I got news for you, Jack. You just misgendered that hen over there, because what you're calling a rooster identifies as a hen. So I don't know what you're talking about. I mean, you can go over there and talk to her right now. I mean, she identifies as a hen. So if you want to keep misgendering what you call a rooster, well, we're just going to have to take it up. You're just going to exacerbate the PTSD I got going on having dealt with you people all this time. You know, this has become a real burden to me. And I've had to get a PTSD diagnosis thanks to you folks.
All right, I'll let that pass. But you also have a structure put up with no permit. Let's go look at that.
Well, what structure are you talking about?
That greenhouse up there.
Oh, is that what you think that is? No, I got news for you. Once again, you're mistaken. That is not a greenhouse. That's not a high tunnel. That's, look, I'm going to keep it real with you. That is my fortress of solitude. Now, Superman was allowed to have one. So can I. That is not a greenhouse. I don't know what you think you're seeing there, but that, if you look at it, that is just my fortress of solitude. And frankly, it's needed for all of the emotional turmoil you people have put me through, arguing with me over things concerning my genderless rooster, or what you seem to want to call a rooster. Also, these places I go to find safety and security. I need a safe space from time to time. In fact, I've already had enough here. You're going to have to bear with me for a minute. I need to get a hug. I think I can go on now. What other issues do you have?
Those sheep over there. Those clearly aren't allowed at this HOA.
Sheep? Is that what you just called them? No. See, you're activating my PTSD once again. Those are not sheep. Let's walk over here and I'll talk about what they really are.
These three are clearly sheep here. You're not allowed to have sheep in this HOA.
Say what? Brother, you need your eyes checked because these are clearly therapy dogs. They all got names. In fact, my other dog, which you didn't seem to say anything about a minute ago, another therapy dog, sleeps with them every night. Now, if these weren't dogs, would that dog want to sleep with them? Ain't that right? Ain't that right, Luther? See, look, they'll come to me if I call and everything. The whole nine yards here, look, you people are just trying to waste my time. You're activating my PTSD. I need another hug. You see that? Your words triggered him. Look at this. Does that look like the normal behavior of a dog to you, especially a therapy dog? He's supposed to be there for me. Now I got to be there for him. Hang in there, old boy. Hang in there. What other problems you got?
All right, so you have a bull up the mountain here. That is a clear violation of this HOA as well. You can have cows, but you can't have bulls here.
Look, I'm getting real tired of you people aggravating my Agent Orange. So we'll go on up here and go look at said bull, and you're going to find out once again you're mistaken.
All right, sir, that is clearly a bull. And we have a testosterone limit here this close to Asheville. Anything over 98 pounds is not allowed to contain testosterone.
See, I about had it with your toxic masculinity. Now, if she were up to it, I'd get me another therapy hug. See, I got news for you. This ain't a bull. This here is a cow. I don't know what you think you're looking at. In fact, I've been milking her twice a day. She'll follow me anywhere I go, long as I got a bucket. I know for a fact. Look, could you possibly milk anything other than a cow? So look, about had it with you and your toxic masculinity. You've offended all my friends out here, my therapy animals, what you call a rooster, the whole nine yards. Look at this. Would he be behaving that way if it weren't for all these unbelievable toxic questions here? I about had it with you folks. I mean, I guess you folks have just come out here to just mess my whole day up. You haven't even acknowledged my two other friends standing here. Ain't that right, Jim? And little Billy Bubba Jack Jim Jr. over there. You didn't even say hi to either one of them. So look, it's time. I suggest you take your camera, you take everything else, you raise on up and get off the property. All right, folks, that's how you deal with these authoritarian people holding clipboards, these bureaucrats that want to tell you how to live your life. But if all else fails, there's always the nuclear option.
Is it because I'm black?